Hey guys, so today I'm here with yet another book haul video. I've been learning that when it comes to shopping for books, I literally have no self-control whatsoever. None. So today I have 6 lovely books to show off to you guys, and yeah, that pretty much sums it up, so let's get started. Book number 1 that I have to show you guys will probably come as no surprise whatsoever. And that book is Impulse by Ellen Hopkins. If you've been watching a lot of my videos recently, you will probably have noticed that I've just been reading a lot of Ellen Hopkins books because they're just awesome. That's pretty much how I can describe it. I think her writing style is incredible and just creative and just so different from everything else I've been reading. And her stories are also so moving and powerful and deep and just blah, lots of emotion. And so I figured I'd give Impulse a try next. This cover also just really grabbed my attention in the bookstore. It's just so bright and vibrant and red and just blah. It's like in your face color, and it just caught my eye and I couldn't say no. The next book I have for you guys is a book that I think I went to like 2 or 3 different bookstores looking for and they didn't have it, and that made me really sad. So when I found it, I got really, really maybe a little too excited. And that book is The Knife of Never Letting Go. I honestly had never even heard of this book until I was watching like a bunch of other booktuber videos and everybody was like, this book is amazing, you have to read it, it's awesome and great and just everything. And so I figured, okay, why not? I don't know a lot about the story. I think it has kind of a dystopian type vibe to it, so that's pretty cool because I actually haven't read a dystopian in a while. Shocker. And I'm hoping that I really get into this book because I would love to read the 2nd and 3rd book in this series before the summer ends, so I can just get one good series done before the summer comes to a close, which is really sad to talk about, so just no. So yeah, I'm really happy I finally got my hands on this book, and I'm hoping it's as good as everybody has been saying it is. The 3rd book I have to show you guys was a purchase I made from the Barnes & Noble bargain bucket because I gotta save some money, right? Yeah. And that book is Room. When I saw this in the clearance rack, I knew it looked familiar. I knew I'd recognize this from somewhere or someplace or someone, but I didn't know what it was about. I think I even read the little blurb on the back of this book to find out more about the story and was still a little confused and not like fully informed to what I'd be reading, but I figured I would give it a chance anyway. I got this book for $7 even though it's in perfect condition and it's hardcover. See? Yeah. Yeah, you don't get hardcover books for $7 that easily. You don't. So I figured I just couldn't resist a good bargain, so I picked it up and I bought it and I have it now. So yeah, definitely let me know if you read this or if you know more about this book in the comments because, frankly, I'm clueless. And the next book I got is a book that I have been dying to get my hands on since it came out in paperback, and that book is Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children. Before I was booktubing and before I got into reading again, my sisters and I would always go to Barnes & Noble and go straight to this book because we loved the photographs and we loved to find the weirdest picture or the creepiest person in this entire book. And I just think it's really funny that I finally have this book now and I don't know anything about the story even though I've like opened it 400 billion times. And I also just think it's a really cool idea to incorporate photography into a story. It's like a picture book for young adults. And we all love picture books. We do. So yes, I am really excited to get started on this book. I want to get it done before summer ends because I feel like everybody else has read it but me, and I've only heard good things. So yeah, definitely pumped, definitely happy I got my hands on this book, and yeah, really psyched, really happy. Even though it's kind of creepy, I think it's going to be a good read. And the last 2 books I have to show you guys are books that I bought at a cute little used bookstore I've been visiting more frequently because used books are cheaper. So the first book I got at this used bookstore was Godless. I have a really bad habit of only buying books that I recognize. If the cover of a book isn't familiar to me, or if the title doesn't ring a bell, or if I haven't seen other booktubers talking about it, I just am not inclined to go buy that book. I never really go out and look for books on my own that I might be interested in. I just always go off other people's recommendations. So buying this book was my way of kind of breaking that cycle. I have never seen this book before. I've never heard of it. Maybe it's super popular in BookTube and I'm just ignorant or something, but I've never heard of it, and the story just really appealed to me, so I figured I'd give it a shot. It's about this one boy who's just fed up with his parents' religion and the religion he's been brought up in, so he decides to create his own religion where the town's water tower is his god. And I don't know, I just thought it was really creative, really different, and I figured why not? Just why not? It's also super short, like, I think it's less than 200 pages. So I could definitely get it done in a day or two, and it would be a good, quick, interesting read. So yeah, that's what everybody wants, right? Yeah. And the last book I have to show you guys is Up in the Air. Maybe some of you will remember this, but I think a few years ago this was made into a movie. So when I saw this sitting in the bookshelf, it definitely looked familiar, and the story sounded pretty interesting, and the best part is... Are you ready for this? Get ready. Get super pumped, because... it's actually autographed. I hope you can see I'm not a liar. So that was a pretty cool surprise. And I also figured it might be nice to read this book one weekend and watch the movie another. Because I have nothing better to do. Literally. So yeah, I don't think I'm gonna read this book like right away, but I am really excited I found it because it seemed like a really cool purchase, especially since it's autographed. Yeah. Yeah. So there you have it. Those are the 6 books I purchased recently. In the comments below, please let me know any of your thoughts, opinions, concerns, whatever, on any of the books I just mentioned, because some of them I honestly don't know a lot about. So I could really use your help. As always, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you soon. Bye!